What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, and today I'm bringing you a brand new video where we're going to be talking about the best SMG in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Now, full disclaimer, and I feel like I have to talk about this at the beginning of every video where I talk about the best of something. These videos are, for one, subject to change. Obviously, a game like Black Ops 4 being released only about 2 weeks ago, a little over 2 weeks ago, is gonna keep getting updates, right? They're gonna continue to balance the game, they're gonna update the game, they're gonna release new things. They might even release new submachine guns in the future that we don't have access to now. So of course, this video is, again, subject to change. Also, it is based on my opinion, but also the opinion of many other professional players in the Call of Duty community. So your opinion may vary, and you might be really good with a gun that I don't talk about in this video, but most of the pros and most of the community agree with what I'm going to be talking about here today. Now, I am going to be talking about the best submachine gun in Black Ops 4, but I'm also going to be talking about some runner-ups and some other guns that you can also use in those close-range engagements. So without further ado, let's talk about the best submachine gun, right? Let's just jump right into it. The best submachine gun in Black Ops 4 is the Maddox. Yeah, you heard that right. The Maddox RFB is clearly meant to be a submachine gun that they accidentally put in the assault rifle category. Now, I'm obviously just trolling. The Maddox is the last assault rifle that you unlock in Call of Duty Black Ops 4 multiplayer. The gun plays so much like a submachine gun that, honestly, I always forget that this is an assault rifle. It's a very short weapon. Like, when you aim down sights, you can move very fast, especially with the stock equipped. It has a high rate of fire. It's great close range. It's better close range than at a distance, unlike many other assault rifles, especially things like the ICR. And overall, the Maddox just plays like a submachine gun. Even players in professional scenes are talking about the Maddox and how it's probably going to be used in a non-assault rifle way. Now, I want to continue to talk about the Maddox, but I don't want to jip you guys. So I do want to tell you what the best submachine gun is in Black Ops 4, and that is obviously the SOG. The SOG 9mm is almost the only submachine gun that is usable in any sort of realistic sense. And that means, like, consistently doing well with it, regardless of game type, connection type, things like that. The Spitfire and the GKS are both kind of in a second place, tied for second place, but they're not even close to the SOG in terms of effectiveness in multiple different maps and different settings and different game types. Now, I don't want to get too far ahead of myself and start talking about all these weapons all at once, so let's return to the Maddox and the SOG. Now, if you look at the stats that are portrayed on the create a class menu, which typically aren't the most accurate, but just to give you kind of an idea of how these guns operate, comparing the Maddox to the SOG, you'll see the Maddox has a higher damage, much better range, and only slightly less fire rate. On top of that, it has a 40 round magazine, whereas the SOG only has a 36. So it fires slightly slower with higher damage, much better range, and more bullets per clip. To me, that just sounds like something you can spray and pray with at close range. The benefit of that, though, is that the gun is actually pretty accurate. I mean, you can still do really well medium range and even sometimes long range with the gun. And that's kind of the inherent problem with submachine guns in this game. It's not that the submachine guns themselves statistically on paper are terrible. It's the fact that the way that the maps play in this game, there's lots of different head glitches with long lines of sight where you really do need an assault rifle to hit those ranges. In other Call of Duties, this might not have been too noticeable or too big of a difference, but in a game with 50% more health, every single bullet counts. So when you're playing with a gun like the submachine guns in this game, the bullets don't really feel like they're doing that much damage, especially at the ranges that you're probably going to be shooting these head glitches at. And that's why the assault rifles are absolutely dominating on pretty much every single map, every single game type, every single game mode, and every type of pro player is pretty much agreeing that the assault rifles are dominating. So when you have a gun like the Maddox, which is pretty much a perfect hybrid between assault rifle and submachine gun, it almost feels like any instance where a submachine gun would be usable, you might as well just use this assault rifle instead. Now, typically when I'm playing with the Maddox, I'm going to be running fast mags, quick draw, and stock. The iron sights aren't that bad, and the operator mod at this point, the Echo Fire, is kind of useless. It seems like the worst operator mod out of them all, especially because of how many create a class points you need in order to use it. So for now, sticking to fast mags, quick draw, and stock seems to be the best way to use the gun. Of course, you can also use fast mags 2 or stock 2, or even laser sight 1 and 2 would be good for running and gunning and really getting those hip fire kills. But as a general purpose class setup, fast mags, quick draw, and stock are going to be your best bet. Now, if we talk about the SOG, which is technically the best submachine gun in the game, the attachments that you're going to want to run on this gun are exactly the same as the Matic, which just goes to show that the play style is very similar. Again, the Matic has better range and it's going to be better at those medium range engagements, but the SOG is kind of like it has a more hyper focused purpose, and that is really getting into those close range engagements, and that's where it's gonna shine. Maps like Summit are gonna be where you're gonna decide whether you want the SOG or the Matic, and it's in those instances you're gonna want the SOG, especially with those close range engagements, because it does have a higher fire rate and it will be better in an indoor environment, and there's really no competition. Again, like I said earlier, the Spitfire is decent, the GKS is also decent, but both of those submachine guns are really not even close to the SOG in terms of how good they are. The GKS is a little bit more accurate, so you can kind of use it more like a medium range assault rifle, and the Spitfire is like the Vesper from Black Ops 3 with ridiculous recoil. So if you really want to get in people's face, the Spitfire is probably your best bet, because it absolutely melts people, but only if you can hit all the shots, and that's really the problem with that weapon. And that's why the SOG shines. I mean, the SOG does both of those things way better, because it adds a lot more consistency with its well-rounded stats. If you ask me, a lot of these submachine guns do need a buff. If they leave the SOG the same, I think that would probably be okay, but the rest of the submachine guns could use a little bit of a buff. I'm kind of scared of the Spitfire, because if they do anything to the recoil of that gun, I think it's going to absolutely melt and you're gonna see a lot of it. So I'm not sure how to fix that weapon specifically, but the rest of the submachine guns definitely need some work, especially the Cordite, because the Cordite is very similar to the Spitfire and the SOG in terms of the types of engagements that you would use it in, except it's worse at pretty much everything. I'm pretty sure that if you get into a one-on-one engagement with a Spitfire, the sheer rate of fire of the Spitfire is going to absolutely demolish the Cordite in every single engagement, and the SOG just has much better recoil than the Cordite does anyway. So the Cordite is kind of like the worst of both worlds, and you really never get a very good game with it. And the MX9 is kind of just underpowered all around, and that doesn't leave you with many good options. Again, like I said, the assault rifles are dominating this game based on a lot of different factors. The submachine guns probably do need a slight buff. The maps themselves are designed to favor assault rifles as well, and the fact that we have 50% more health and a longer range of sight in a lot of these different gunfights really puts submachine guns at a disadvantage, because they do lose damage over range much more than the assault rifles do. And that's pretty much it, guys. That's all I have for you for this video. I just wanted to share my thoughts about the status of the submachine guns. As I said earlier in the video, this is subject to change, and Treyarch is obviously looking at the stats of these weapons and their win rates and how well people are doing with them. And I'm sure we're going to see a balance update in the very near future. Like I said, we don't know when these balance updates are really going to come out. So by the time I upload this, there could already be one, or it's already announced or something like that. So please forgive me if there has been new information released since I recorded this video. There's nothing I can really do about that. I did my homework before recording this. I searched for all the patch notes and everything that they've already announced. Nothing I've seen so far has talked about submachine gun balancing specifically, but I would not be surprised if we saw an announcement like that within the next couple of days. And that's been it, guys. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a thumbs up and comment down below what you think about the status of the submachine guns in this game. Do they need a buff? Are you cool with the assault rifles dominating? And comment with a thumbs up emoji so I know you made it all the way to the end of the video. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you subscribe, smack that bell button, boy, and I appreciate every single one of you who are part of the notification squad. I always see you guys commenting first, and I really, really do appreciate it. Especially the ones who drop a comment, get to the end, realize that they should have put an emoji in it, and then drop another comment. Those are the homies. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.
Yep.
Yeah.
TACOM requesting UAV eyes on.
UAV above.
They're all on trees, by trees. Two by three.
He's weak.
Bomb, get on bomb.
Oh, I hit the fuck.
Lemon squeezy.
Hell yeah.
Welcome here.
Let's get this done.
Let's get it.
Yes, yeah.
Oh, dude, I'm gonna use Seraph and I can redeploy. Nah, you can't edit classes while in the game.
Does that actually work, Micah?
What? Yeah, it does.
That seems broken.
Sergeant and destroy.
Charge acquired.
It allows one revive.
Eliminate the objectives.
But it takes like to round 5 or something to get it. Alright, I'll watch flank. I guess. This works.
Motherf***er, dude, I'm so bad at
behind us.
He's dead.
One on boat.
One hostile remains.
Yeah. He was in the hallway of the boat. I don't know where he went. He's in the little room of the boat.
Yeah, he ran around, he dropped out the window.
Bomb acquired.
I don't want to chase him.
Nice.